Yeah, hi there. These comments are for Carlo. This is Michael. I'm the founder, owner, and the materials writer for the 7-step system to pass the TOEFL IBT. And I'm going to clarify a little bit more of what Jacob was telling you in the score that he gave you. Now, remember, I can't do this all the time, but you had a quick question. So he gave you a score of 3.25 or 21. So I 100% agree with the score. This essay will not score higher than this. You might even score lower. Now, the main thing is your essay, I just took a word count of it. It's about 205 words. So what you need is you need 350 words. So you need to add about 150 words to what you've already written. So it's true. You definitely need more development of ideas. Okay, so the first thing you have to think about, maybe, which is a little bit difficult, is you have to think about what kinds of dances you have in your culture. For example, my culture. We have ballroom dancing, which is a very formal type of dancing. We have what's called square dancing, which is a type of dancing that people do in the South. It's a country type dancing and country music. We even have more freestyle dancing to either rap or pop type music. We even have type slow type dancing. Each of these types of dancing, they reveal certain aspects of the culture. Now let's take a look at one of your paragraphs. You say in paragraph 2, expressing feelings and points of view is really an important aspect of dancing. Many of the movements used in a performance have a special meaning. But what movements, what dance? You're not naming any specific dance. You say they have a special meaning, but you're not telling what that meaning is. Does it mean happiness? Does it mean sadness? You say sometimes dancing is used to tell folklore stories. Again, if you mention that, you have to give an example. In general, it says a lot about the culture and the society. It says what about the culture? So when Jacob says you need more development of ideas, you do have to get more specific as to what you're trying to say there. Now, what you want to do is compare what you've written to the model. I put a model essay that you can go to after you get your essay scored. You can read a model which will show you how to write this kind of response. Now let's compare a minute the models. Remember, yours was 209 words. Now if we take a look at the model, let's do a word count on that one. This one's probably closer to 500 or 600, but let me take a count just quickly. This is 494 words, the model essay. So the model essay is almost 300 words more than what you've actually written. So let's take a look at an example. I just read your paragraph, right? So let's take a look at the second paragraph of the model essay, the writer says. And this was written, believe it or not, by someone at my website from India. It says, ethnic dances and certainly popular dances anywhere around the world have associated preferences for costumes and special clothing. Through dances, the participants are able to reveal and express their chosen role in the garments they choose. Social roles in the dance are shown a public ally to the observers as well as the other dancers. Frequently, dancers utilize objects like swords or sticks or hoops or musical instruments to further reveal information about their role in the social story portrayed in the dance. Items such as special headwear and jewelry are further examples of the garments that in general express preferences and culturally significant details about the particular culture. Now my question for you is how is this paragraph different from yours? Right? It names things. It says things like swords, sticks, hoops, musical instruments. It brings up the example of special headwear and jewelry and other types of garments that help express preferences and culturally significant details about the particular culture. That's what you have to do. You have to get more specific in the body part of your paragraph, in the middle parts of those body paragraphs. You need to be a lot more specific than you are right now, or you will get the same score over and over and over. Let me put it this way, Carlo. I'm sitting down to eat dinner. Here's what I want. I expect a salad. I want my main course. Maybe my main course is roast beef, potatoes, and green beans. And then I want a dessert. Maybe ice cream or something. Now, obviously, I shouldn't be eating that because it's too fattening, but that's not the point. So I sit down and you're preparing me dinner. What do? You give me a salad. Now, am I satisfied, Carlo? No, I'm not. Why not? Right? Because I was expecting dinner and you only gave me a salad. So in your essay, you actually had certain expectations that you needed to resolve or you needed to meet in order to satisfy, I think, the expectations of your audience, the reader. And because you didn't give specific ideas or specific details to support your generalizations, I was not satisfied. And I felt like I had more of a salad when I was actually expecting a main course. All right, so the next time, what you want to do is, at this point, here's my advice. Don't worry as much about the time when you do your next essay. But what you want to do is, I want you to sit down, look at what the writing prompt is, and then you can go back and write in your Microsoft Word or whatever, but try to write about 400 words answering the question. And then go to the website and paste it for Jacob to score. So what I want you to do is, I want you to double the size of the essay that you've written. Now the other thing that you haven't done here is with your essay, you have four paragraphs. You need a conclusion, which is paragraph number 5. And you didn't do that either. So that also hurts the development of your ideas and a little bit of the organization. Because the purpose of your conclusion is to kind of tie up all the loose ends of the essay. Right? So your score, I think what Jacob was saying is you do have a pretty good organization. You have good control of your vocabulary and your grammar. That's all good. You got a lot of good things, but you need to put more details in the body paragraphs. Remember that the TOEFL IBT human raters, they want a main course. They want dinner, not just a salad. So by giving them dinner, you have to think of specific examples to help support some of the generalizations that you're using in the writing. All right, have a great day. And by the way, Happy New Year. And if you like my course, tell somebody else about it. I know things are not perfect. I can't make everything completely perfect for every student, but I try to do the best I can to help students reach their goals. All right, one other thing. Something that might help you, I think, in terms of raising your writing score and in allowing you to put more details in your writing is the vocabulary section of my course. So it could be right now that you're a little bit weak with your vocabulary. You need to improve and learn more vocabulary words, and that will help you express ideas of a more specific nature in both the independent speaking and integrated speaking, and also the independent and integrated writing tasks for the TOEFL IBT.